Let's study about Stoke's law and terminal velocity. This is a very important law, and it is somehow linked with the previous section. Just now we have discussed that, just we write down the situation we have described in the previous slide. That is, when a body moves through a fluid, we can say the fluid in contact with body is also dragged with it. And this will happen when the fluid is having some adhesive forces with the body in contact. Then we can say if it is dragged with the body, as the fluid particles which are in contact with the body will stick to it because of adhesive forces, we can say, and the relative motion between fluid layers oppose the motion of body. Actually, we can say, when the body is moving, fluid layer which is in contact with the body is dragged along with it. So due to viscous forces, that fluid layer is opposed, and as it is in contact with the body and it is dragged along, we can say the motion of body is opposed. And the Stoke's law is directly linked with this situation. And here we can write, according to Stoke's law, the viscous force on a sphere of radius r. We are assuming that a sphere of radius r is moving over the speed v through a fluid of coefficient of viscosity eta is given as, this is the direct expression for the viscous force acting on the sphere. It can be given as 6 pi eta r v. If v is the speed of the sphere, here we can say if there is a liquid in which a sphere which is of radius r is moving at a speed v, then here we can say that those fluid particles which are in contact with the sphere will stick to it. And these fluid particles are also moving with the speed v along with the sphere. And those fluid layers which are in contact with this layer will oppose the motion of this fluid layer, or the force will directly act on the sphere as the closest layer is already stuck to the sphere. So we can say this viscous force is acting on the sphere, which is given by 6 pi eta rv. Right now we are not going for the derivation of this expression. Here you just keep in mind, as the speed of a sphere will increase, we can say the viscous force will increase, as well as it depends on the radius. Remaining other parameters are constants, including 6 pi and the coefficient of viscosity. Let's also find out the case of a terminal velocity when a sphere is dropped in a liquid having some viscosity. Let's continue on the next slide. Let us consider a case when a sphere is dropped in a fluid. See what will happen. Say if there is a liquid in which a sphere is dropped, we know well that this will experience gravitational force mg in downward direction. Its weight will act in downward direction, and due to this gravity it will accelerate and its speed will increase. Along with this, it will experience a buoyant force in upward direction, plus it will also experience the viscous force due to the concept we have just now discussed in the Stoke's law. So we can say, as due to its weight, as the speed increases, this viscous force also increases. So after some time, the two forces will balance the weight of body, and the body will attain a constant velocity. As when weight is exactly balanced by these two forces, no further increase in velocity will take place, as acceleration becomes zero. So we can say, when a sphere is dropped in a liquid, then due to viscous forces, it attains a steady uniform speed. And this happens because viscous forces increase with the speed. So, as this is increasing, at some point of time, these two forces will balance the weight. So, we can say to steady uniform speed, say it can be written as Vt, which is called terminal velocity or terminal speed, at which we can write acceleration of body becomes zero. That implies the buoyant force and the viscous force will be balancing the weight of body. In this situation, say if we take up rho s is the density of a sphere, that is the density of solid of which the sphere is made up of, and rho l is the density of liquid in which it is flowing, and eta is the viscous coefficient. In this situation, this buoyant force is because of the weight of liquid displaced, which can be written as 4 by 3 pi r cube, which is the volume multiplied by density of liquid into g. That is the buoyant force. This is the weight of liquid displaced, which is equal to the volume of the sphere, plus viscous force. We can write 6 pi eta r vt. Vt is the terminal speed it will attain, beyond which no further increase in velocity takes place. This must be equal to the weight, and mass m can be written as 4 by 3 pi r cube into density of solid, that is the mass of body, into g. Now in this situation, we can see this pi gets cancelled out, and in this situation, this 1 r will also cancel out in this expression, and on solving this, we will get the value of terminal speed, which is written as 2 by 9 r square, density of solid minus density of liquid by eta multiplied by g. So this is the expression you should keep in mind. That is the expression for terminal speed of sphere which is dropped in a viscous liquid which is having a coefficient of viscosity eta.